under the World Trade Organization, Article 1.2, if I'm not wrong, there is a requirement that every government, every country would publish the import-export information on a portal so the traders can be given guidance and advice. They should know what to expect, what kind of forms to submit for getting a license or a certificate, what would be the fee structure, what legitimate fee they are supposed to pay, for example, how much time would it take. So we created this trade information portal. We were supported by this, for this by USAID. The underlying toolkit was provided by the World Bank. But the information portal itself was created by one of our own team members from Pakistan Customs, who is now working in Single Window as a domain officer. So the Trade Information Portal provides complete guidance on import, exports and transit procedures. It has a lot of data that previously was not available to the general public. So every month we update the data for imports and exports. It's not firm level, but you get summarized data of our imports, exports with every country for every commodity.
For example, you can have refined searches of particular HS codes, but if you don't know the HS code, you can use the commodity name, you can write the product name and search all the relevant documentation, what are not only the documentation but also the trade statistics as well, that what kind of business is and what kind of trade volumes we have on that particular commodity on the HS code within a span of time. So that information is something which is actually sold using the CDs earlier on, but now it's freely available.
Any company from anywhere in the world which is looking to do business with Pakistan, in Pakistan, with Pakistani partners, can explore and understand Pakistan's trade procedures, its laws, as applicable to their specific area of business.
You can get a subscription and get monthly updates on the items of your interest, for example. I think the biggest contribution that we have done is digitizing laws. When I was in the public sector, well, I still am in the public sector, but when I was in the government service, for my work, if I had to consult a law, I had to make a Google search. And usually the law would come up as a PDF document. And it would be so difficult to go to that particular piece of law that I was looking for. Under the Trade Information Portal, what we have done is digitize them, so they're like searchable documents. I think more than 250 laws have been digitized. You put in a keyword, you want to import maybe a bird, the Trade Information Portal will give you complete guidance on what procedures to follow. Who would be your contact point, which NOCs you would require, what would be the tax structure on that. If you want to look at the law behind it, you can take a look at the law behind it. And now we are also bringing other enhancements. So we are not only giving information for Pakistan, we also have embedded the international tools in that. So if you're exporting to the US, for example, we would also let you know what kind of compliances you have to achieve for making sure that your product can enter the US market. Our effort on the Trade Information Portal is to make sure that the portal is relevant, it's updated. There's a whole governance framework behind it to make sure that it remains updated all the time. So for example, the budget that was recently approved and got implemented July 1st, the Trade Information Portal was updated within 1 week. So you now have completely updated information. We are also going to add more value-added services. So for example, in future, it would be possible for a trader to access the Trade Information Portal and through it, get due diligence conducted for their foreign buyer. You want to, for example, export something to Tanzania and you are not aware of your exporter's profile. So your buyer's profile, and you are a little bit, you know, kind of reluctant on to know whether I should get into business with them or not. So we are integrating third-party services. You can avail those services to find out the profile of your potential buyer in Tanzania, which we believe would help enhance those trade connectivity relationship between foreign buyers and Pakistani sellers.
So in the medium to long term, this intervention should make Pakistan a friendlier country to do business with, and it should solve and address a lot of documentary challenges that are faced by our Pakistan's domestic exporters and externally companies that themselves might be importing from Pakistan or are exporting the products to Pakistan.
We deliver a very niche service, right? It's a service to only those people who are associated with cross-border trade. At this point in time, there are 81,000 people who are subscribed to our portal. So maybe 100,000 people are involved in cross-border trade. So we have not really reached out to the common person, but we think that going forward, we already have these plans as part of our communication strategy. Now we need to start making Pakistan single window as an identifiable brand within the masses as well. So even if you are not involved in cross-border trade, you still identify Pakistan single window as a government, as a national institution that you should be proud of.